I was almost a failure. I was almost a rejected person. But somehow, I trust on my skills, I put my sincere efforts, my mentors helped me, and things work for me. Like, I came to Egypt because I got internship at Gamaltech. You can see a camel on my back. And it's my really pleasure to work with Gamaltech, because at Gamaltech, I found my colleagues from Turkey, Dubai, Tunisia, all over the world. So it's a great opportunity to me. Hello everyone. Are you alive? I hope so. The girl who sang a song, she was fantastic. And you guys are giving me amazing energy, amazing vibes. I can't describe even it in words, but you are making my day special, and I am thankful for that to you. So, first and most important thing, a very kind namaste from India to all of you. Namaste. My name is Akshar. I am from India. And today, I'm gonna share just two things to you, because I know speaking on the stage is easy, but to sit there and to listen is tougher job. And you guys are doing that. Speaking from the stage is not so hard job, but listening from there, sitting for a long time, is a really tough job, and I really appreciate all of you for that. So I begin my speech. What is the first thing? When I started learning programming, everything was so cool. Like eat, sleep, code, repeat. You know, when we started learning programming, putting cool stories, snaps on social media, hashtag programmer, hashtag changing the world, and so kind of things. So when I was learning programming, I was thinking that people will come to me with the ideas of apps, startups, but people come to me with a very weird questions. One of my friend come to me, hey bro, I want password of my neighbor's Wi-Fi. Can you hack my neighbor's Wi-Fi? Seriously? Another thing, one of my friend come to me, hey bro, I love one girl, but she blocked me and her Insta account is private. Can you hack her Insta ID? Listen bro, if I know how to hack Insta ID, why should I be single? But it's a sad story. All my brothers sitting here know, because some problems have no solution. But let's back to our topic. Programming is not just about hacking things. Programming is something special. It's something connected to our hearts. Let me more elaborate this. Who are we? If we see on social media, people will say programmers are like fatty guys, introvert guys, sitting on the computer for the all day. But we are special. We are not less than any superhero. Do you believe programmers are superhero? Okay, if you believe, then it's good. If you not believe, let me say something to you. Why we are superheroes? Let me share you one story to you. Two guys stuck in a windfall. They were in Paris and they thought, what if we can book a cab by tapping on our phone? The idea was amazing. They developed an application, and today we all are using that application. I'm talking about Uber. Why we are superheroes? Because we have a power to get an idea, to see things first in our hands, and then we make millions of people see that things in their hands. So we make our imagination a reality to the world. Rare things are always precious. You know diamonds? All the girls love diamonds. Why diamonds are so precious? Because diamonds are rare in nature. SMS, now listen, is amazing statistics. In this whole world, there are 8 billion people. Out of those 8 billion people, only 0.5% people can write a code. So me and you, we are all those 0.5% of the world. Let's give a strong applause to yourself, because you are special. We are special. Steve Jobs used to say that everyone should learn programming because to learn how to code, it teaches you how to think. Yeah, that's right. Because when we learn programming, our smartness increases. It enhances our problem-solving skills. That's the reason why programmers have 10x more smartness and problem-solving skills than chess players. So first thing I want to share you is give a tap on your back, appreciate yourself because you are super special. Second thing I want to say is that I born in India and you know India. People everywhere. 1.4 billion people. In my college, there are 500 seats. And to get into my college, I compete with 50,000 people. You can imagine how tough the competition is. So like when I born, in the big ocean of Indian population, I was nothing. I was almost a failure. I was almost a rejected person. But somehow, I trust on my skills, I put my sincere efforts, my mentors helped me, and things work for me. Like I came to Egypt because I got internship at Gamaltech. You can see a camel on my back. And it's my really pleasure to work with Gamaltech because at Gamaltech, I found my colleagues from Turkey, Dubai, Tunisia, all over the world. So it's a great opportunity to me. So what I want to say to you is that, you know WhatsApp, right? The most famous messaging app in Southeast Asia is WhatsApp. WhatsApp was developed by a guy born in Ukraine and moved to USA. The most popular games in US and West, PUBG, Clash of Clans and Flappy Birds, came from the developers of Finland, Ireland and Vietnam. So what I want to say in last is that it's the idea that matters. It doesn't matter where you come from, what your background is, or how large the competition is. You are the ones, yes, you are the ones who are building next Google, next Tesla, next Spotify, next, well, we don't know, but you are the ones who are building the next something very special. Thanks for listening to me. Shukran. And Egyptian people are so kind. I would really appreciate if you come to me, if we have a conversation. So in backstage, anyone can come to me. We will have a cool photos and a good talk. Thank you.